Want to know whether your friends prefer Captain America or Iron Man? Or perhaps you're curious to know what parts of your business customers think need improvement? Well, let me show you how with Paperform's ranking field. Hey everyone, Alex again from the support crew at Paperform, and in today's video, we're going to take a look at how you can gauge customer preferences and ask them to rank items within a question. Ranking fields are great for questions that relate to preferences and habits, and not only is it an awesome way to better understand your customer or audience, but you can also obtain quantitative feedback that you can then apply to your business. Now, for the sake of this video, I've gone ahead and created an example form where I ask my coworkers to rank their favorite Avengers. I've also created a name question so I can attribute a ranking to each member of our team. Now, like with all question fields within Paperform, there are two processes we can follow to create a ranking field. The first is to click the Add Questions icon we see on the left-hand side of our form editor. Or if you already have a question field, clicking the Add Question button that we see appear below. And then once we've done that and created a new question field, we'll select from the drop-down of field types there and click rank. The second process is to navigate to a blank line and type a forward slash followed by rank, then hit enter on your keyboard and voila. Now I'm quickly going to delete one of these and it's time to configure our ranking field. First and foremost, we want a question title. So I'm going to click into the section there and I'm going to ask my coworkers to please rank the Avengers from your most favorite to least favorite. All right, now let's actually jump into the configuration settings of this field by clicking the cogwheel icon we see on the right-hand side. Perfect. Now it's time to create the options or items that we will ask our submitter to rank. We can see there that we've got the dummy choice one, choice two, etc. So we'll click into there. Now it's important that we list each item on a new line so the form editor knows that that's an individual option. So I'm going to type the Avengers. Let's go with Iron Man, of course, Captain America. I've got to put Hulk in there, definitely. And Black Widow, as well as let's go Hawkeye. All right, perfect. Now we've set up the ranking field, but we can actually achieve a bit more. Personally, I only want my coworkers to rank their top three Avengers. So if we scroll down, we'll see the ability to toggle off rank all items. I'll click that. Then we'll note we have the ability to set a maximum and minimum number of answers. So all I need to do is set three and voila. It's that easy. So let's jump out of the configuration settings and take a look at this field in action. I'm going to jump out there, head up to the top, and we need to save changes. Then we will click on the eye icon there to view the live view of our form. And voila. All right, now we're in the live view of our form. Let's actually take a look at how the submitter will respond to this ranking field. We see there we have the ranking items or options. Then if you select a particular option, it's going to go to that first ranking. You select your second and third and so on. The submitter can also use the interactive drag and drop icons we see on the right-hand side. Or they can also opt for using the manual selection, whereas they click on that value, and then they select where they would like that particular item to be ranked. Once they've completed the form, they can click submit, and that's it. If you have any questions regarding the ranking field, let us know. And seeing as you're still watching this, leave in the comments below who your favorite Avenger is. Personally, I have to go for the Hulk. And speaking of, make sure you Hulk smash that like button and subscribe to the channel for more useful tutorials. As always, thank you for watching and happy creating.